Hi, Facebook friends. Welcome back to Lucia's Kitchen. I'm so excited. My kitchen is finally finished. I went through some major renovations and I'm excited to start cooking in my new kitchen. And now that Easter's approaching, I decided on a rainy Saturday, why not start baking my favorite cookies? And today's cookie is a prune butter cookie. This recipe comes from generations of mothers from Italy. My mom's from Italy, born and raised, and this is a cookie I grew up with. You need 2.5 cups of flour. You need 1 cup of sugar, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 2 sticks of butter or margarine. My mother grew up using margarine, I use butter now. This is Earth Balance, which is more of a vegetable blend. 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla, 3 eggs, and famous prune butter. This is the brand that I buy. It's very hard to find, so I order it off of Amazon. So let's get started. So we dump our flour on the cookie board. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna kind of make a hole because you're gonna put all your stuff in the center of it. Okay, put your sugar on the outside of it, like on top of it, doesn't matter. Just gonna spread that over. This is so easy. Okay, make like a little, make sure you cover all the corners. Make a nice circle. Okay, put your eggs in the center. It's 1 egg. Okay, this is what it's supposed to look like when everything is in the center. So you have your butter or margarine, your vanilla, your eggs, your baking powder. So, all right, now the fun begins. We gotta mix all this. So you're just gonna cut right through. See what I'm doing? You can use this little knife. I'm just gonna cut through. Okay, now I'm at a point now that this is pretty mixed. Now I'm gonna use my own hands. So what you're gonna just do is you're just gonna knead it, just like that. Try to form a ball. Okay, now we're ready to start. So what I do is I sprinkle a little bit of flour on the cutting board. Just cut a chunk. Well, you know, it depends how big you want to make these. I'll take this. So you're using your hand the whole time. You don't need a rolling pin, but by all means, if you feel you want to use that, you can. I just use the palm of my hand and I just kind of expand the dough. Now you can make it as thin as you like, or as thick. I try not to make it too thin because then the prunes bleed out, which is okay, it's really good. It gets nice and gooey. Okay, oops. And if it breaks apart, like I just kind of broke a piece, kind of just add a little flour and just kind of, put it back together. There you go. All right, so now I take a little bit, like a teaspoon, I drop it on, I kind of spread it. And once I spread it, I'll bring the camera closer so you can see what the, so here we go. What it looks like. That's how we're gonna start baking them once the sheet's all filled. And then I kind of flatten a little bit. And it'll expand more when we cook. So we're ready to put the cookies into the oven. So here we go. So my oven's at 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock is only 400 degrees. I'm doing good. So you should wait about a good minute before slicing. Sometimes I'm impatient, so I do a diagonal. So do it very gently, and I just move it. And you can make them as thick as you want. So see, I need to wait. See how that broke off a little bit? So let's wait a minute. That's how I gauge, you know, but let's just see. to just be careful. I would wait 1 or 2 minutes before cutting. Put this back in. And I just 5 more minutes. Let's look at the cookies again. All right, just see, these cookies are really nice and brown. This is how I like it. If you want a little bit darker, you can keep them in a little bit longer. It's not going, just make sure you don't burn them, but they're perfectly fine. You can't really kill these cookies by overcooking them, all right? But let's look down here. Look at this tray. This one went in afterwards. See, if you like them this light, by all means, you can take them out. But I like them much more brown. So I'm going to leave those in. I'm going to leave them in the cookie tray for about 2 to 3 minutes. And we'll get the spatula and remove them carefully so they don't break apart. So here we go. So we get the spatula. And I put them on parchment paper.